والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. From the book of الترغيب والترهيب chapter الترغيب في بناء المساجد في الأمكنة المحتاجة إليها. The encouragement and the reward in building مساجد in the places where it's needed. In the places where it's needed. So this is the title. Not just building the masajid is such a virtuous act, of course, as we would hear, but especially in the places where it's needed. And this is such an act of goodness that we need to pay attention to. And look at the places where there is needed to have masajid and to do our best and to take the means to build masajid. The hadith عن عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه أنه قال عند قول الناس فيه حين بنى مسجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إنكم أكثرتم وإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من بنى مسجدا قال بكير حسبت أنه قال يبتغي به وجه الله بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. The hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, من بنى مسجدا, whoever builds a masjid, يبتغي به وجه الله, seeking by building the masjid, the وجه of Allah. وجه الله, the face of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the believers will see Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the day of judgment. And this is an intention that a person would have when he do good deeds, to seek this ultimate pleasure and the most rewardable thing whatsoever for the people in Jannah when they get to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and nothing is the like of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, with that being in mind, seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rewards from Allah. The reward of it, bana Allahu lahu baytan fil Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for him a house in Jannah. So the one that would build the house for him in Jannah is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And no one can ever even imagine how would that be. How beautiful there is, ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. No eyes have seen, no ears have heard, no hearts have ever imagined. And as the ulama, they say, it doesn't have to be that the person build the masjid from A to Z. And anyone that has a share in building the masjid, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. The reward, as we heard. And another hadith which shows, again, doesn't matter whether it's big or small, The hadith of Abi Dharr رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من بنى لله مسجدا قدر مفحص قطاه بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. Which means whoever built a masjid قدر مفحص قطاه, which is the size of where the bird it has its nest and to have eggs in it. You know, when the birds in whatever the season they make their nest fit enough to feed their eggs. The Prophet ﷺ said, whoever built a masjid like this, very small. بَنَى اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build the house for him in Jannah. So it doesn't have to be something that is a mansion. And when it comes to building the masajid, there are rules and ahkam to be applied and how to spend the money in building the masjid and to make it comfortable and to make it pleasant. And all of that is perfectly fine. But the issues with tashyid in masajid, which is one of the signs of the hour. And the Prophet والسلام, he said, مَا أُمِرْتُ بِتَشْيِيدِ الْمَسَاجِدِ I was never commanded to build the masajid in a tashyid is when you build such a humongous structures and for people to look at it and say, wow, this is a beautiful structure and things like this. This is from the signs of the hour. But rather, again, it's to be comfortable, to be nice. All of that is fine, but going back to the subject here, the reward of building a masjid. And the most important, which is masjid, the most important job in it is the salah. So if the salawat is to be established, and then of course the other things comes with it. But something in the West, as you see, when a masjid is built, there's the tendency of building everything else with it. A gym and a swimming pool and all kinds of halls. MashaAllah, it's good to bring the community together. Yes, it's needed. I'm not belittling it. But it doesn't have to be either this or nothing. Right? We are in need of masajid. We need to have masajid where people come and pray and listen to matters of the deen and to benefit from it and go home. Right? And not every time we come to the masjid, it has to have everything with it. Right? So this is something to think about. It makes it even easier when it comes to spending and having the feasibility of having many masajid instead of waiting for the opportunity to come to build a big structure. So to think of that and never to belittle the action if it's needed. Again, with the condition that it's needed in the community or something like this. Even the masjid, if it's very small and people would pray the 5 daily salah, and they can close the masjid to pray Jumu'ah, for Salatul Jumu'ah, they close the masjid to go to a bigger masjid. This is something that from the early generations of Islam, they would do that. That's why the concept of al-masjid al-jami'ah. The masjid al-jami'ah, one masjid in the whole town, will be the masjid where Salatul Jumu'ah is established. And all of the small masajid are closed. Why? Because everybody would come and gather in that one big masjid. Of course, you know what, it doesn't fit because of how the cities are big and it's not feasible, but I'm saying it's as far as the principle of the ruling here, if the masjid is very small, never to belittle a place for people to make salah, what constitutes a masjid, not a rented place or so, this is a musalla, but to make a masjid, even if it's small, in an area where people are in need of it, mashallah, this is not something, is definitely better than not having a masjid. And there are more hadith, but we'll stop here, inshallah. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.